Hello and welcome to our 17th SOP lesson. This time we finally landed to something much, much more interesting. It's about the dynamic simulation in SOP context. However, this topic is limited to few operators. It provides still a lot of possibilities, and especially if we start to speak about the particles. In modern times, everyone is looking for the GPU particles because they provide the possibility to simulate millions of points. But for that, they don't provide that kind of complexity and easy way of controlling stuff. So, and I don't think it's a time completely to forget the CPU particles provided by the TouchDesigner, because we can do a lot of interesting things using it. So let's dive and check what we can do. So first I just show one of my projects created for the how to touch course for the particle lesson. And here you can see how we can control the attraction of points using the panel interaction. Imagine how you will create this using the GPU particles and how much time that will take. And now let's dive into TouchDesigner and see what can we do. Okay, in order to create particles, we need to have some geometry and we need to create a particle SOP. Let's make a small walk through the particle parameters. So we have here the state page, forces page, particle page and limits page. State page defines the basic settings of the particle system. Here we can select the render type, if it will be the lines after the rendering or the point sprites. Then we can use the particle system as a particle system basically, or modify source geometry, which will actually act as deformer. Then we have time increment and maximum steps. I don't think it's a super good idea to change something here. Then we can reset particles. And for later topic, for attractor, we can use all points or single point per particle. Then second page are basic forces. And here we have external force and wind. So let's make kind of dynamic, kind of gravity and kind of wind. So if we take a look now with the same value, wind have actually less effect than external force. What is the difference? Difference is that external force apply the changes in velocity immediately. So it's kind of force particle to move to that direction vector. And wind try to move particle to that direction. And it depends on the parameter called drag, which is to find under the particle page. So more drag, more will the wind force affect the direction. That is kind of not very clear for most of new TouchDesigner users. Then we have a turbulence, and we have a turbulence period and turbulence seed. Okay, next page are particles. We can add here the particle ID, and that's a super important parameter, because if you will use particle points for something like instancing or for copy geometry, and you will rely to the point number will jump every time the particle dies. So if I will create now the Sopto dot, and we will see that every time index changes after the particle dies, and if we create the particle ID, every time the particle dies, it generates new ID numbers. So in that case, instead of using the point number, you should use the ID attribute. Then the all expressions or your instances will not jump every time the particle is died. You can also add mass attribute, add drag attribute. Then you have birth, parameter, this is the amount of particles are born per second. That means with default settings, TouchDesigner will generate 100 points per 60 frames. Then you have life expect, which is also in seconds. So that means every particle will live for 3 seconds. You have life variance, also in seconds, which will make the random lifetime per particle with range of, in that case, half of second. Then you have alpha speed parameter, which will change the alpha transparency of particle relative to the speed. Then you have surface attraction. Surface attraction is activated if you provide the attractor, but we will check it later. And last page is limits. This is a collision behavior, and you have two types of collisions. You can provide the collision geometry, or you can provide the limit plane. By default, the limit plane is set to 1000 TouchDesigner units on all axes. But you can, for example, move it to minus 2 TouchDesigner units, and you will see that something changes, that particles are basically deleted if they touch this virtual plane. So if I reset the particles, you will see it better. So here we can change the particle behavior to 3 options: die on contact, bounce on contact, and stick on contact. Also, we have additional way to generate new particles on contact. That can be no splitting, split on contact. In that case, I can set it to die on contact, and that settings, original particle will die on contact and generate 3 new particles. So this min max splits means how much particles will be generated per particle and represented as a range. So 3 by 3 means it will generate 3 particles in any case. But we can also make it more random and generate from 1 until 3 particles per particle. And also we have an option to affect the velocity of newly generated particles. We have the hit behavior, and here we have gain tangent and gain normal. So that will be activated if we use bounce on contact. So let's first remove splittings. Imagine if your particle is flying to the surface. That is the surface. So you have a normal on surface, and you have the tangent vector, which is parallel to the surface. How your particle will bounce on contact depends on multiplication factor on the normal and tangent. That's are these 2 parameters, gain tangent and gain normal. So if I will multiply tangent more, they will fly more in horizontal direction. And if I will gain normal, they will jump higher. And also split on contact, we can add velocity variance or remove velocity variance. Then they will be affected by the original settings set here. Gain tangent and gain normal, and we can add velocity. So we can add velocity, for example, in y direction. So it's quite flexible.